Hello, my Disney Dreamlight Valley friends. It's Underwater Fish here, and today we're going to be doing a speed build of my garden in the Forest of Valor. I get asked about this one all of the time because of the specific pathways I use. It looks like they're garden beds. If this video was in any way helpful to you, I would appreciate it so much if you liked this video and subscribed to my channel. We all know that Wally's house is a little bit clunky and a bit ugly, but this is a great way to hide his house and also keep it with the same theme. Wally does have his own garden, and so I wanted to keep Wally with that garden and also build a bigger garden that Wally can kind of take care of for me. All right, let's dig into this. Here's an overhead shot that's going to give you all of the dimensions that you're going to need. The garden's dimensions with the fence is going to be 25 squares by 31 squares. There's 9 garden plots total, 6 of them are 4x5s and 3 of them are 5x5s. And for the pathing, starting from left to right, we have 5, 3, 3, 3. And then top to bottom, we have 2, 3, 3, 2. Do you remember that the fences take up 1 square? Now that we have the dimensions of everything, let's go ahead and begin the build. Start with a clear area. This doesn't have to be done in your Forest of Valor, but this is where I personally thought it went best. You're gonna wanna start in the back here because that's going to make it easier so you're not guessing where exactly do you have to start near the entrance. It's gonna line everything up perfectly for you. First, you're gonna put down Wally's garden. Then after that, you're going to get the mud path and create a base for Wally's house to be placed on. It's okay to leave little gaps because you're gonna cover it up and it saves on resources. Then place Wally's house on top of the muddy path. Then you're gonna wanna build out the fencing right in front of Wally's house. I like to use the trellises because that matches what's in Wally's garden already. You might be wondering how I figured out the best way to make this all even, and this is how I did it. I just dug holes all the way from one end to the other of this area so that I knew how many holes there were. Then I did the math to figure out what the most optimal and efficient way was to create this garden. Then I did the same thing going straight up. This allowed me to figure out how many high I could build so that I could do the math to make sure that everything was really even. As a reminder, make sure you have a digging buddy with you. That way you get all of the extra items while digging. I'm really showing you this just in case you don't want to use the same layout that I did. You can create your own layout and figure out what's the most optimal option for you. If you don't want to have to dig all of these holes and you just want to use the layout that I have created, then it might be easier for you to just start using the paths instead of having to dig all the holes first. Using the holes that you just dug, you can now count until you get to the area where you can start digging out your garden. We know that it's going to be 4x5, so we want to make sure that we have that many holes dug in one area. For the middle spot, we know that it's going to be 5x5, so we're going to dig that many holes. I really use the yellow part of the shovel that's on the ground to help count out the different spaces. Sometimes it's good to stop where you're at and just double check that everything does line up, because it's easy to get one line off by accident. And so don't be afraid to just stop before you move to the next garden plot and make sure it's lined up. This is honestly the longest part about this entire build. Once you have this done, it's smooth sailing from there and really easy to do. You can see with all of this building why it's so important to have that companion there with you. You're getting so much extra stuff. Even if you don't need to dig anything, you're getting a bunch of materials from this anyways. Once you have all of the holes dug, you're just gonna wanna go back and remove all of those extra holes that you had dug to make sure that everything was lined up. There's a couple ways you can do this. Personally, using a rug does not always work for me. So since there's not that many holes to dig up, I went ahead and just used my shovel to get rid of them. Now that all of your garden beds are built and you've gotten rid of all of the extra holes, you're gonna go in and add the leaf-strewn path with borders. This is what's going to give it that garden bed look. The wood that surrounds it makes it look more like a garden bed. I do want to call out that by the time I put all of this path down, I realized that I did everything one square off. Mistakes do happen, they're easy to fix. All I did was move everything down one, so I got rid of one row of each garden bed and added a row to the other side. You'll see at the end here that I end with 4 pathways on the left side. It really should be 5. And so the next scene, you'll see that everything is shifted down just a little bit. Now we're going to add the white picket fence, making sure to leave a gap at the entrance so that you can walk into the garden. I used a front-facing view to make sure that the gap was wide enough also. I wanted to hide the area into the plaza a little bit, so I put up the trellises along this wall. That way it kind of tied in the trellises in the backside also. Here you can see that I'm using the garden bed in the center to make sure that the white picket fence is lined up evenly. Now we get to decorate. Some great items to use are crafted items like benches, flowers, burlap bags, a rustic wooden case, flower boxes for Wally, a birdhouse, or even a sack. I also use some non-crafted items like rusted trash cans, lightning strike wagon. I put one of Anna's picnic sets on each side so you can have a picnic in the garden. And since I use this as a pumpkin farm, I thought the pumpkin lamps were the perfect fit. Plus, also adding a lunch pail would be nice for the picnics. To make sure there was enough light, I crafted 10 wooden lampposts with blue lights. And don't forget to spruce up Wally's area with a couple cute flowers, just to give it a little bit more life. And for the entrance, I used 2 lush trees to give it a little bit of an archway, and an autumn harvest pennant that I crafted at the crafting table for an entryway. We can't forget about the gooseberries out in the front. The last thing you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna go back to your red wagon, drop some vegetables out from your inventory, and then you can place them into the red wagon like you're carrying them around with you. After this, you just have to plant your vegetables, and there we have it, Wally's garden. Well, it's really your garden, but we let Wally take care of it for us. If this helped you, please make sure to like this video and subscribe for more content, and let me know in the comments what you think of this. Thank you so much for watching.